There is a cave. have so much fun. We have a chaotic and come try it. There is our campaign.
We have a chaotic encounter. unconscious neuroscience has recently published a study on people with a condition called visual form agnosia. Such individuals cannot consciously see the shape or orientation of objects, yet act as though they can. If you hold up a pencil in front of them and ask them if it's horizontal or vertical, they cannot tell you. But remarkably, they can reach out and grab that pencil, orienting their hand correctly as they reach out to make contact with it. This documents a great advancement in the understanding of the visual systems that govern conscious and unconscious sight. These findings correspond with studies conducted on the unconscious mind of animals. In one such study, finches trapped on the Galapagos Islands and sent to California showed innate fear responses to hawks, even though there had been no predator bird on their native islands. The finches had not been exposed to the sight of a predator bird for hundreds of thousands of years since this innate response first evolved, but somehow still remained in their unconscious processes. The same can be said when showing images of unknown objects and places to humans. Some will provoke feelings of danger in the viewer, while others are seen as calm and peaceful. The World Institute of Unconscious Neuroscience believes that we are all agents of the system at any given moment, and only relatively few are aware of this, but even fewer still able and willing to take steps to counter this unconscious manipulation. A great metaphor for the state of the average psyche today, a mind that can at any time be taken over by the unconscious processes and remain unaware that this has happened, becoming an agent of the system by virtue of being dominated by external authority and not possessing enough developed internal context to fight back. In order to further their understanding of how the unconscious mind processes information, they will be conducting a new study on Jungian numerology, the theory that every single number has meaning. They believe in the basic premise that human brains are constructed in such a way that certain themes, motifs, and representations are baked in. That's what they refer to as the collective unconscious. For instance, light representing redemption, renewal, and prosperity, and the night representing danger, despair, a need for caution, a period of hardship, and evil, are built into our neurochemistry and are not merely constructed through external factors. As always, they are looking for willing participants who will want to help progress their understanding in this innovative field of science.
Yeah.